Are we ready to march? Are we ready to march? Are we ready to march against right to work? Are we ready to march against emergency management? Are we ready to march to support affirmative action? Are we ready to march to keep voter rights across the nation? Are we ready to march? All right. Certainly we're thankful for his presence that was here, and now we are thankful to have the presence of his son. I want you to put your hands together, stand on your feet, give it up for Martin Luther King the Third.
Detroit is still a great city in America. And it is because of what has come out of this, from out of this community. And so don't let anybody tell, oh, Detroit is going down, things are bad. People always define negative things. But there are many positive attributes within this community. Right this moment. Now, I'm glad, I'm so thankful. I was praying that I didn't have to speak after Brother Sharp. Lord, I know I was sweating. I've learned, although I've been around preachers my entire life, my great-grandfather was a preacher. My grandfather was a preacher. My father and his brother were preachers. My sister's a preacher.
Racism, militarism, and violence I connect together.
American citizens. You may remember in the first part of the speech, the I Have a Dream speech that all folk talk about is that first part. Dad talked about a promissory note. And he said that when that note was taken to the banks or the vaults of America, that a check came back marked insufficient funds. So we forget about that part. All we think about is the rhythmic part of it. And so I still have a dream. Well, that is certainly relevant, but today, the catastrophe is even larger. That shack was never cashed. And as a result, there are systemic problems throughout our nation. There was a foreclosure crisis. It took place over the last 3-4 years, starting in 2007, 2008. Many Americans thought that they had overcome poverty. In fact, they were out of the category of poverty. They were moving toward middle class. And then the foreclosure crisis caused them to be thrust back into an impoverished category. Now, the problem that I have with the issue is that those who created the condition for those unfair loans, they knew when they created them that people would not be able to sustain those loans. And so they were looking out for short-term gain, but ultimately creating long-term pain for millions of Americans.
Yeah.
the president or the commander-in-chief. There is a forum to address the commander-in-chief if he or she is not telling the truth. But you don't disrespect. We haven't seen any other president in our lifetime, and a member of Congress, and we know there were a whole bunch of presidents that told a whole bunch of things that we found were not true. That's just one of many issues that show us that racism is still alive in America. We have to find a way to reach internally and make our nation a better nation for all Americans. That group is fortunately not in the majority. That group that still harbors these racial attitudes, but they're well armed. They have all kinds of rifles and guns, assault weapons. You know, I'm one who believes we need to abolish. Why do we need assault weapons anyway? I mean, I'm not against those who want to hunt. I never did. I don't necessarily believe in having guns, but if that's what you feel you need, that's your prerogative. But an assault weapon? I mean, if you hunt, I mean, it's not even fair to the animal. I mean, there's no sport in assault weapon utilization. I mean, how can we be in a nation where we can't even get the provision for checking on people? Congress won't even pass that. That shows what time it is, ladies and gentlemen. And that's why we have to come together. And while many of us will march down Woodward tomorrow, and many of us will come to Washington as we observe the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington on August 24th. Militarism and violence is the last thing I want to talk about, because we are spending billions and billions of dollars on military affairs. And then in our communities, every week, we are gunning down our brothers and sisters. Every day, someone's being killed over foolishness. Now, we're God's highest creation, human beings. But when we attempt to resolve our conflict, we operate at lower health animal levels. What I mean by that? We get mad and want to pick up something and hit somebody, kill somebody, when we have the ability to reason. I see, God's highest creation. I mean, you never seen monkeys talking about Plato and Socrates, Euripides, Harriet Tubman, Sojourner Truth, W.B. Du Bois, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King. They don't have that ability. You never see a bunch of dogs talking about they're Democrat, they're Republican, they're Tea Party, or they don't participate. They don't have that ability. You never see a bunch of cats talking about I'm Baptist, I'm Catholic, I'm Jewish, I'm Muslim. They don't have that ability. But mankind, God's highest creation, has the ability to think and reason. And when we become angry, we resort to lower animal forms of resolving our conflict. When are we going to learn to treat our fellow human being with dignity and respect? Nothing in return is totally selfish. You love someone if they're old or young, many things that we can say that are wonderful, but the time has not come for celebration. We observe, but we continue. And quite frankly, it is because women and men have sacrificed that we've made the progress that we are making. I went to school, when I got me a degree, learned how to make my subject and verb agree. Now people sending me letters, I don't know what they mean, so I gotta carry a kid around with me. What does this mean? See, I understand formal, a sentence, but I don't know what those letters mean, so I have to learn a whole new method of communicating, a new vernacular. But guess what? That's the way of the world. Either you learn it, or you become obsolete. So we need to tweet. We need to use Instagram. We already using Facebook and all of that. So the social media is so important to get our message out, to bring people to the table. I assure you that if my father were alive, he would be encouraging us to embrace social media. So as I prepare to close, I want to encourage you not to get anyways tired. The song says, I am nowhere tired. Why? Because we've come much too far from where we started. You see, no one ever told any of us that our roads would be easy.
Give Martin Luther King III, one of our National Action Network Michigan chapters.